buffel grass is a weed, it's a pest of a weed, and it spreads like a disease. And it's, you can say it's like a disease. It spreads right across that land, and it's just hard to get rid of, but we're doing it, and we're trying our best to get rid of it.
The main number one threat is buffel. Basically, buffel can destroy people's homes, and it can destroy animals' way of life, you know. So you need the country, you need the animals to hunt, you need the plants enough to keep. Because with that, once they're all gone, basically you've got nothing left.
We're here to get together and try and find a solution that we can go around and do it together.
Buffel grass has been identified by us and others as one of the key threats to biodiversity in the arid land. So 10 deserts covers an area of about 2.85 million square kilometres. And within each of those areas, buffel grass is a problem. It was brought out in the 60s after about 20 years of overgrazing in central Australia, and the dust storms are so bad that they couldn't actually bring planes into Alice Springs. So what they did back in the 60s, they planted it out in the airport, about 8 of these different varieties. It started spreading all over the countryside. And if you've been to central Australia or Alice Springs, you'll see buffel grass everywhere. And it's hard to talk about buffel grass as a weed, because when it's everything that you can see over all the hills, it's pretty hard to tell people, oh yeah, see that grass, it's everywhere, that's a weed and we need to do something about it.
We're in Junjunjara, in the Spinifex lands, and the Spinifex Rangers are here burning buffel grass to create a bit of a backburn to protect the community. As you can see behind us here, buffel grass has a huge fuel load and birds incredibly hot and fast, and it poses a big risk to our Aboriginal communities and Indigenous communities out in Spinifex country.
We come back and sometimes and spray it and it's all burnt out.
Each individual plant contains thousands of seeds, and every little fruit contains between 3 and 5 seeds. So they rapidly respond quickly to small amounts of rain, and are prolific seeders. They produce huge amounts of seed and therefore have the ability to rapidly invade our natural environment and cause devastating effects.
Spreading everywhere in the community, around the houses.
We didn't know we had them there till the Spinifex mob came there and showed us how to spray them and all that.
And so what we're hoping is that through working together here and having people involved in other jurisdictions, that we can start pushing both the NT and Western Australian governments to also look at buffel as a weed and see how we can start working across borders and across countries to be able to deal with buffel grass, because it is one of the key threats to biodiversity. It takes over landscapes, and the only way that we can deal with these wicked problems is by dealing with it together.
Buffel grass is one of the priorities in the Spinifex Healthy Country Plan, so it's one of the threats to Spinifex lands, and we've currently been funded through the National Landcare Program and Rangelands NRM. They fund the rangers to help map and manage the buffel grass. There's only quite a small amount here around Junjunjara community and along some of the roads, so it's certainly manageable with advice from our friends in South Australia who've done, from the South Australian Buffel Grass Task Force and AWNRM, they provide a lot of technical advice to us to help with our war on buffel grass.
The Kero grass has knocked that out, but the buffel, scarolina and some of the other grasses have come back.
Those sorts of things, to start up a little native seed nursery. You know, you can go out and seed collection.
Seeing that everybody doing work in the same job and makes us feel proud as a ranger, and especially me, you know. I see it on Spinifex country, and that's the thing that I learned, and it goes out to everybody who does the same job. Go back home and feel proud. Just go home and do the work. The little things that you do, it makes a big difference if everyone's doing their part.